Today, I'm going to deliver Rearranging Lecture 15 on problems of convergent and divergent sequence. That means, here in this lecture, I want to go into through some problems or some theorems of convergent, and I will discuss about the divergent sequence. Right? In last lecture, we have discussed about the squeeze theorem or sandwich theorem and problems of sandwich theorem. In this also, I want to find convergent sequence by some squeeze theorem or sandwich theorem. Okay. And also, I will going to discuss about the divergent sequence. Right? Theorem. Lim of n tending to infinity 1 by n power p equal to 0 for p is greater than 0. Limit of n tending to infinity 1 by n power p equal to 0 for p is greater than 0, right? You may call p test also. This you may call p test also, right? Why? Because for p greater than 0, there will be convergence. If p is less than 0, this series is divergent. For sequence p test, why I am calling this? You can simply observe here, I want to do, what can I do here? So this sequence, so I am writing here this sequence. Limit of one by n power p equal to 0 if right? So p is greater than 0, right? So that equal to infinite if less than 0. So infinite, right? So 1 if p equal to 0. So this test is called p test, simply, right? P test for sequence. Oh, that means this simply you can that 1 by n power p, the sequence 1 power is converges at CGS if p equal to 0, whatever, 1 by n power p, n power 0 equal to 1, 1 lim of 1 equal to 1, so that is p greater than 0 is 0, 1. That means if converges, if I want to say that greater than or equal to 0, diverges, okay, if p is less than 0, right? So this kind of problem, so I will going to discuss in this topics. Before going to divergent to converges, I want to explain divergent. Later we have to discuss about this theorem, that is p test, convergence per divergent. I am going to discuss in this topic convergent as well as divergent of problems. So this p test especially is for convergent and divergent. This sequence is convergence if p greater than equal to 0, divergent if p less than 0. This thing you have to remember, right? So for this I am going to discuss first of all convergent. Later we have to discuss about the divergent. For before going to some problem, I want to prove some theorem. Lim of n tending to infinity 1 by n power p equal to 0 for p greater than 0. Second one, lim of n tending to infinity a power n equal to 0 if mod a is less than 1. C, limit of n tending to infinity n power 1 by n equal to 1. D, limit of n tending to infinity a power of 1 by n equal to 1 for a is greater than 1. So this theorem I wanted to prove here now. Right. First theorem. Limit of n tends to infinity 1 by n power p equal to 0 for p is greater than 0, right? So already we know that about this limit of n tends to infinity 1 by n power p equal to 0 for p is greater than 0. This kind of problems already we solved, right? In place of p, we may put that 1, 2, 3, 4, anything. Simply what I am taking away. Let Sn equal to 1 by n power p. P is greater than 0. L equal to 0, right? Let epsilon greater than 0. I am considering that mod Sn minus L is, I am considering mod Sn minus L. Sn nothing but 1 by n power p. L nothing but 0. So mod of n 1 by n power p minus 0 equal to what happened? Only 0, right? Here 1 by n power p. Which implies mod of Sn minus L equal to 1 by n power p. Why? Because any generation number, if you add power super natural number, we will get only positive number only. So for that, if I put mod or modulus, nothing will happen. That's why I am writing 1 by n power p. This is less than epsilon according to concept. Which implies what I am taking here 1 by n pi n power p is less than epsilon. N power p is greater than 1 by epsilon. Here, so n is equal to what happened here? I am taking here n is greater than 1 by epsilon whole power of 1 by p. So 1 by epsilon whole power 1 by p, that equal to m I am taking. 1 by epsilon whole power p, that equal to m I am taking, right? For all here, this is integral part I am taking. M is equal to, I am taking integral part of 1 by epsilon whole power of 1 by p. For every epsilon greater than 0, there exists m belong to m is equal to integral part of 1 by epsilon whole power 1 by p belongs to z space, such that mod of 1 by n power p minus 0 is less than epsilon. Which implies limit of 1 by n power p equal to 0 for p is greater than 0. So we have shown. This implies that 1 by n power p, limit of 1 by n power p equal to 0 for p is greater than 0. B. If mod a is equal to 1 and mod a power n minus 0 is equal to mod a n equal to, that equal to mod a whole power n. So let I want to show that, what can I show? I want to show that limit of n tends to infinity a power n equal to 0 if mod a is less than 1. I want to show this. For that, I am considering here mod a is less than 1. And for this mod a less than 1, mod a, I already know that mod a n power minus 0 is equal to mod a n power, that equal to mod a whole power n. Both are will be same. Let mod a equal to, I am taking 1 by h, 1 by 1 plus h, for h is some positive. Why? Because if I take any value, this h is positive, then which is less than 1 only. Mod a is less than 1 only. If I substitute any value, h is positive here. Mod a n whole power n equal to 1 by 1 plus h whole power of m. Mod a whole power equal to 1 by 1 plus h whole power of n. This is in the form of 1 plus x whole power y, right? 1 plus x whole power n, 1 plus h. By apply binomial theorem, okay, it is written as nc0 nc1h plus nc2h square plus nc3h cube divided as ncn, right? This is looked like nc is nothing but 1, nc1 nothing but nh, nc2 nothing but n minus n into n minus 1 by 2 factorial by h square divided as n into n minus 1 n minus 2 by 2, so 6, that is 3 factorial, that is into h cube. There as h, ncn equal to 1, that equal to h power of n. Right? So, which is less than or equal to, see here 1 by n plus h plus I required this less than or equal to, I am taking that. 1 by 1 plus nh plus dash, which is less than or equal to 1 by 1 plus n. Why? Because this term 1 by nh plus, right? So, simply can observe here why I am writing this. So, one by one plus nh plus some terms only into h square plus h power of m, which is greater than or equal to y, because this term 1 plus n h. I am adding this extra terms here. I am adding this extra term here. Yeah. 1 plus nh plus 1 plus nh is equal to 1 plus nh. If I add in this, what we get here, 1 by 1 plus nh, this term extra we have, therefore, which is greater than or equal to. If I reciprocaling, that means 1 plus nh n into n minus 1 by 2 h square h 4 of n, right? So which is less than or equal to what how can I write here, 1 by 1 plus n h. So which is less than or equal to, I will write here 1 by c, which is greater than or equal to nh. Why? Because I am adding extra term here. 1 plus nh is greater than nh, which is less than or equal to nh. This time are required. So this is the way here happened. Okay, so it is less than 1 by nh. That means, so mod a whole power of n is less than or equal to 1 by nh. So I am taking this 1 by nh is less than epsilon. I know that mod a n whole minus 0 is less than epsilon. Here nothing but nh is less than epsilon. Nh greater than 1 by epsilon. M is equal to, how can I take here? H comes this side. M equal to what happened? Integral part of 1 by h into epsilon. Integral part of 1 by h epsilon. Which implies, for every epsilon by 0, there exists M is equal to integral part of 1 by h epsilon belongs to z plane, such that mod a n minus 0 is less than epsilon for all n greater than equal to m. Which implies lim of a n whole power of n equal to 0. Lim of a n whole power of n equal to 0. Okay. Second b is over. Next, I want to take that lim of n into n power 1 by n equal to 1. So this thing will be easy to show last later. Now it is, I am going to show in difficult way. Let S n equal to n power of 1 by n minus 1 is greater than or equal to 0 for all n belonging to n. Which implies S n is greater than or equal to 0 for all n belongs to n. Which implies n power of 1 by n equal to 1 by S S n. Lim of n power of 1 by n equal to 1. Here S n equal to n power of 1 by n minus 1. I want to show that limit of n tend to 1 by n equal to 1. For that I am considering here S n equal to n power of 1 by n minus 1, which is greater than or equal to 0 for all n belonging to n. Which implies, so Sn is greater than 0 for all n belongs to n, which implies n power of 1 by n equal to 1 plus Sn, that equal lim of n power 1 equal to 1. Okay. So I want to show this is right. N equal to what happened here? N power of 1 by n equal to 1 plus Sn. N equal to what happened here? 1 plus s power whole power n. By apply binomial expression, what can I write here? N equal to 1 plus n into Sn plus n into n minus 1 by 2 Sn square. That is S n whole power of n for all, which is greater than or equal to this extra term we have here. 1 plus n S n is greater than or equal to this extra term we have here. That's why I am writing this 1 plus n. Why I am writing this? I required some proof, right? For that, I am like, sorry, 1 plus n S n. Which implies what happened? Which implies n is greater than or equal to 1 plus n S n for n greater than or equal to 2. Which implies n minus 1 is greater than or equal to n S n. Which implies n minus 1 by n is greater than or equal to Sn. So which implies what happened here? Sn is less than or equal to n minus 1 by n for n greater than or equal to 2. Let epsilon greater than 0 such that Sn is less than or equal to n minus 1 by n is less than epsilon. If I take here, this is happen for n greater than or equal to 2 only. It happen if n greater than or equal to 2 only. So I am writing here with epsilon epsilon, if AB, M is equal to minimum of 2, this is epsilon, right? If from this I am writing here, N is integral part of box epsilon, right? If I take this minimum of 2 comma 1 by epsilon, from this I want to simplify N, right? N minus 1 by N is less than or equal to 1 by N. Implies M is equal to what happen, 1 greater than 1 by epsilon will come. So if I take M is equal to minimum of 2 and box of 1 by epsilon, that is integral part of 1 by epsilon. Therefore, for every epsilon 0, there exists epsilon chapter such that mod Sn minus epsilon less than 0 for all integral to M. So for all epsilon, there exists M equal to integral part of 1 by epsilon belongs to chapter such that here. Okay, you can apply here easily. N minus 1 minus 1 equal to like this. Okay. M is equal to 1 by epsilon, how we will get here? From this I will get, okay, N minus 1 by N, that equal to lima 1 minus 1, that equal to 1. So what I am writing here, same thing, I am writing here similar way. So 1 by N is less than epsilon, 1 by N is less than epsilon, N is less than 1 by epsilon. So similarly, I am taking that, for every epsilon is it, take this M belongs to integral part of 1 by epsilon belongs to place such that N power 1 by N equal to 1 for all is less than epsilon for all integral equal to M. We show that lim of 1 n power 1 by n equal to 0 n power of 1 by n equal to 1. So this thing will be show easily in later. Lim of n power 1 by n equal to 1 you can show easily in later. So now I am applying convergent definition, that's why it is become difficult. By what is difficult? By taking minimum of 2 and 1 by epsilon is difficult, right? From this how we will get is difficult, right? So that means 1 minus 1 by epsilon, 1 by 1 minus n is less than or equal to 1 by n. So this thing I am using here. Okay. If n equal to 1. Okay, this way. Okay, if n is equal to 1. Other way I want to show here. If n equal to 1, what happened? Limit of n power 1 by n equal to 1. So m power of the derivative 1 power of 1 by n equal to 1. If n is equal to Sn equal to this. Sn equal to n power of 1 by n minus 1 greater than equal to 0 for all n greater than n belongs to n. Sn greater than 0 for all n belongs to n. N power of 1 by n equal to 1 plus Sn. N equal to 1 plus Sn whole power of n. N equal to 1 plus Nsn plus n into n minus 1 by Sn whole square. Same as this n greater than equal to n into n minus 1 by 2 Sn whole square for n greater than equal to. From this I am writing here, I am using other different term. What can I write here? 2n by n into n minus 1 is greater than equal to Sn square. Sn square is less than equal to 2 by n minus 1. Sn is than equal to root 2 by n minus 1 for n greater than equal to 2. 0 less than equal to Sn less than equal to root 2 n minus 1. So this is 0, this is 0, this is 0. Here applying Chandwick's theorem or squeeze theorem. I am writing this is Sn is greater than 0 always. Sn greater than 0, 0 less than equal to Sn less than equal to this. Lim of this equal to what happened? 0. This 0 is 0. By squeeze theorem, what happened? Lim of Sn equal to 0, right? So this lim of Sn 0 nothing but Sn nothing but n minus 1 by n minus 1 equal to 0. Nothing but lim of n power 1 by n equal to 0. 1. So this is another method. This is another. So now fourth one, let A equal greater than 1, consider 1 less than A less than N, consider 1 less than A less than 1, right, which implies so 1 power of N is less than A power of 1 by N is less than N power of 1 by N, lim of 1 equal to 1 and lim of N power equal to 1, this one which implies lim of A power 1 by N equal to 1, by squeezer lim of A power N equal to 1, so this is easy. Here I am applying squeeze theorem or Chandwick's theorem. Okay, I want convergent. I found convergence of A power 1 by N. A is greater than 1. So equal to 1. That is by using squeeze theorem. Yeah, some other problem. If lim x n equal to 3, lim y n equal to 7 and y n not equal to 0. For all n belongs to n. Then find A. Lim x n plus y n. B. Lim of 3 y n. x power of n minus y n cube. Here 3 y n x n not x here 3 y n x n. Solution: lim x n equal to 3, lim y equal to 1, lim y n not equal to 0. A. Limit of x n plus y n is equal to lim x n plus lim y n equal to 3 plus 7 that equal to 10. B. Limit of 3 y n minus x n y n cube equal to lim of 3 y n minus x n by lim of y n cube that equal to lim 3 y n minus lim x n. Nothing but lim y n. So lim y n equal to 3. I'm writing here. Y n equal to how much here? Lim y n equal to 7. Lim y n equal to 7 minus 3 that equal to 77 equal to 343. 3 into 7, 21 minus 3 equal to 18 by 343. So this value is 710 and this value is 8 by 312. Right. So this problem is over. Right. We show that lim of x equal to 3, lim of y equal to 7, y n not equal to 0 for all n plus 10. Then find a equal to lim of xn plus yn, b equal to lim of 3yn minus xn by yn cube. Right. So simply this is lim xn plus yn equal to lim xn plus yn, this is 3, this is 7. Next to lim yn, 3yn minus xn equal to, I am simply writing 3 times of lim yn. Lim xn by lim y n that equal to 18 by 343. Because simplify will get other things also, right? Let s1 equal to 1 and sn plus 1 equal to root sn plus 1 for all n greater than equal to 1. List the first 4 terms of sn. First one, list the first 4 terms of sn. B. Okay. It turn out the SN converges, assume the fact. And prove that limit is 1 by 2, 1 plus root s. 1 by 2,
1 plus
1 by 2, 1 plus root 5, I think, right? 1 by 2, 1 plus root 5, right? So what I'm making here, I want to list the first four terms. Here it turns out the SN converges. Assume I want to assume this fact. Then I want to show that the limit of the sequence is 1 by 2, 1 into 1 plus root 5. That means 1 plus root 5 by 2. This I want to show. Let SN is sequence is defined by SN equal to 1, S1 equal to 1, SN plus 1 equal to root SN plus 1 for all n greater than equal to 1. S1 equal to 1, here S1 equal to 1. This is first term. S2 is equal to S1 plus 1. That equal to here what happened? Root S1 plus 1. S1 plus 1 equal to S2. That equal to root S1 plus 1. That equal to 1 plus 1. That equal to root 2. S3 is equal to S2 plus 1. That equal to root S2 plus 1. That equal to root of root 2 plus 1. That because S2 is nothing but root 2. This third term. S4, S3 plus 1, that equal to S4, S3 plus 4, that equal to S3, root S3 plus 1, root S3 at the part, root of root 2 plus 1, that equal to 1, right? So, this is the way we found that the first 4 terms of the sequence. B, I am taking that, we are assuming that it turns out the converges. So, I am assuming that, let Sn converges to L. So, I am assuming here, lim Sn equal to L. Which implies lim Sn plus 1 equal to L. Let Sn plus 1 equal to root Sn plus 1. Sn square plus 1 equal to what happened? Sn root S, sorry, Sn plus 1. Lim of Sn plus 1 whole square, Sn square plus 1. Lim of Sn plus 1 whole square equal to lim of Sn plus 1. Lim of Sn plus 1 into lim of Sn plus 1 that equal to lim of Sn plus 1. That equal to L plus 1. Here lim Sn plus 1 that equal to L plus 1. L1 to L is L square plus L plus 1. That equal to L square minus L is equal to 1. This is quadratic equation in L. We may write x equal to minus b plus or minus root b square minus 4s by 2a. L is equal to what happened here? Minus 1 to minus 1. Plus so root of minus 1 whole square minus 4 times of 1 into minus 1. A nothing but 2, 1. Here in the form of p is equal to minus 1, a is equal to 1, b is equal to c is equal to minus 1. I am substituting these values here, minus 1 into minus 1 plus root of minus 1 square minus 4 into 1 into minus 1, that equal to 1 into 1, 1, minus 1 into 1 equal minus 1 equal to 1, plus this is nothing but 1 plus 4, root 4, nothing but root 5. L equal to 1 plus root 5 by 2. L is equal to 1 plus root 5 by 2. So, since L not equal to 0, that because Sn is positive. Sn is positive, it cannot be negative value. So, okay. If we write root 5 equal to the value is 2.52, that means 1 minus 2.52 nothing but 1.52. Minus terms gives. So, if we write here, it will get minus values. Whatever Sn is greater than equal to 1, therefore L is equal to 1 plus root 5 by 2. Sn is converges to 1 plus 2 into 1 plus root 5. Okay, this problem we have discussed here. Let t1 is equal to 1, tn plus 1 equal to tn square plus 2 by 2 tn for n greater than equal to 1. Assume tn converges and find the limit. t1 equal to 1 and tn plus 1 equal to tn square plus 2 by 2 tn for n greater than equal to 1. Assume tn converges and find the limit. Here tn1 equal to 1 and tn plus 1 equal to tn square plus 2 by 2 tn for n greater than equal to 1. Let tn converges to L. Let tn converges to L. Limit tn equal to L. Limit tn equal to L. Limit tn plus 1 equal to L. Limit tn equal to L. Limit tn plus 1 equal to L. Tn plus 1 equal to here tn square plus 2 by 2 tn. Tn square plus 2 by 2 tn. Tn plus 1 is equal to tn square plus 2 by 2 tn. Lim of tn plus 1 equal to lim of tn plus 2 by 2 tn. Here lim of tn square plus 2 by 2 tn. Lim of t2n is equal to lim of tn square plus 2 by 2 tn. Nothing but lim of tn plus lim 1. Here lim of tn plus 1, right? Lim of tn plus 1 equal to L here. Lim of tn plus 1 equal to L. And lim of tn square equal to lim of tn into lim of tn plus lim of 2 by 2 times of lim of 2. That equal L equal to L into L plus 2 by 2 plus 2 L. L into L is equal to L square here 2 by 2 L, that equal to L. Which implies what happened? 2 L square is equal to L square plus 2. Here 2 L square minus L square minus 2 equal to 0. L square minus 2 is equal to 0. L square equal to L equal to plus or minus 2. Plus or minus root, sorry. Here L square equal to 2, right? L square L square plus or minus 2. L not equal to, since so Tn is positive, therefore here L not equal to minus root 2, right? So L equal to plus or minus root 2, right? Tn converges to 2. We have proved that Tn is converges to 2. Practical problem 4. Here let x1 equal to x and xn plus 1 equal to 3xn square plus n greater equal to 1. Show if a equal to lim xn, then a equal to 1 by 3 or a equal to 0. Does lim xn exist? Explain. Discuss the appropriate contradiction between the part a and part b. See, x1 equal to x, I'm taking that x1 equal to x, so, and xn plus 1 equal to 3xn square plus 1 n greater equal to 1. Show that a is equal to lim xn, then a equal to 1 by 3 or a equal to 0. B, does lim xn exist? Explain. Discuss the appropriate contradiction between part a and part b. A, here x1 equal to 1 and xn plus 1 equal to this thing, a equal to lim xn, sorry, here x1 equal to 1, not x here, yeah? x1 equal to 1 and xn plus 1 equal to 3xn square for n greater equal to 1. If a equal to lim xn, then to show that a equal to 1 by 3, a equal to 0. To verify existence of limit xn and explain. To discuss the apparent contradiction between part a and part b. Principle. Sequence. Limit of a sequence. Convergence of sequence. Lim xn equal to L. Lemme send this one grow out where SN is any SN be a sequence. Method. The sequence XN is defined by X1 equal to 1 and XN plus 1 equal to 3 XN square for N grand equal to 1 A. Let lim XN equal to A, which implies lim XN plus 1 equal to also A. Consider lim XN plus 1 equal to 3 XN square. XN plus 1 equal to what we have defined here? 3 XN square. That's why I am writing here XN plus 1 equal to 3 XN square. Apply limit both sides. Lim XN plus 1 equal to limit of 3 XN square. Here lim xn plus 1 equal to 3 times of lim xn whole square. Lim xn whole square nothing but how much here? Lim xn into lim xn. Here lim xn plus 1 equal to L. This is 3 into A. Oh, here I am lacking lim xn equal to A, right? This is A, 3A and A. That equal to what happened? 3A square equal to A. 3 times of A comes this side. A times of 3A minus 1, that equal to 0. Here A equal to 0, either 3A minus 1 equal to 0. So, A equal to 1 by 3. A equal to 1 by 3 or A equal to 0. A equal to 1 by 3 or A equal to 0. So, that means, if we assume that lim xn equal to A, we have found that A equal to 1 by 3 or A equal to 0. Okay. We've shown that A. B. X1 equal to 1, xn plus 1 equal to 3 xn square plus 4 n equal to 1. Simply, I am observing here x2 equal to x1 plus 1, 3 x1 equal to whole square, that equal to 3. x3 equal to x2 plus 1, that equal to 3 x2 square plus 3 into 3 equal to 27, x4, right? That means 2 n, that rounds of the sequence are going to infinite. So, as n tends to infinite, the values of xn approach to infinity. That also goes to infinity, right? So, therefore, sequence xn is not converges. The sequence xn is not converges. Therefore, lim xn is not exist. Lim xn is not exist. Right. If we assume what is the apparent contradiction between A and C, if we assume existence of limit xn is exist, if existence of limit x of xn is exist, then we will get the values. But according to the perception, the given sequence is not converges. If you assume only it is converges the way we find some values. But if it by appearance, the given sequence is not converges. Result. Lim xn equal to A, then we shown that A equal to 1 by 3 or A equal to 0. Lim xn does not converge, exist, and we explained. We discussed the contradiction between part A and part B. Right. Next, divergent sequence, right? Okay. So, what is divergent sequence? What is divergent sequence, right? A sequence SN is said to be divergent infinity if for every g greater than 0, there exists ambulance at least such that SN is greater than 0 for all n greater than equal to m. So that means I will explain here clearly other way. So here I am writing divergent sequence, right? Right. What is divergent sequence? A sequence SN is said to be divergent sequence if the sequence SN is said to be divergent sequence if for every g greater than 0, so there exists m belonging to z plus such that Sn is greater than or equal to greater than g for all n greater than or equal to. So that means here what happen? So for every g is any bigger number, here if any take bigger number, the terms of the sequence, the terms of the sequence is greater than g only, is greater than g only, right? So for suppose if I take that so I will write, right, let me denote. So this sequence is denoted by this is now limits n equal to as n tend to infinity, limits n equal to infinity, right? For example, I am taking some xn is equal to sequence, this xn is my sequence is n, right? Xn is said to be divergent sequence to infinity, here xn is said to be divergent sequence to infinity. Xn is said to be divergent to infinity. If is said to be divergent to infinity, I want to say that so for every g, for every g is greater than 0, there exists m is equal to the value. So is belonging to z plus such that s n nothing but here n s is greater than here, okay, I will write s n only, s n is greater than g, so that is equal to value, I am writing this was the value for every n greater than equal to. So that means, so what are the terms of sequence here? You can quickly write the terms of sequence here. The terms of sequence are n equal to the sequence terms, how look like, this is n equal to 1, 2, 3 up to so on. Okay. Going like this. The terms are going like this only, n equal, right? See, for every g greater than 0, g is equal to, you can take that. Right. For every g, g is equal to, you can take that. If I take g greater than 0, there exists m belonging to z plus such that Sn is greater than 0. This Sn equal to g is equal to this. This is a sum sub, right? So that means, so we have to find Sn is equal to n only. Sn equal to n greater than g 20 20. For what value of m, right? There exists m is equal, right? There exists m greater than equal to, if I take m is equal to 20 20, or you can take that m is equal to 21 21, m is equal to 21 21 20 21, that means if I take after m equal to 21 21, that means Sn here Sn equal to n, right? So there exists a term m equal to 20 21, so after this term this will be greater than, after this term, right? So that means 20 21 is greater than 20 20, for all here n nothing but 20 21 is greater than 20 21. Grand chronology was 2021 only, right? This is my G. This is my G. This is sequence SN. This is N. This is M. Right? So this thing here happened, right? For if I take G is equal to 2021. There M is equal to what happened here? 20, 21. SN equal to N here, G is equal to 20, 21. Sorry, 20, 21. So, for any year, N nothing but N, after M is equal to here, what can I write here? 20, 21. After 20, 21, the terms of sequence here, grad equal to 2020, grad equal to 2020, right? If you do other problem, that means so simply you can observe here limit of SN, limit of SN is equal to lim N. Here N tends to infinity we have, right? That equal to what happened? Infinite. Lim SN equal to infinite. Therefore, the sequence N is divergent. The sequence N is divergent. Right. If you take other sequence, suppose N square I am taking here. You have to find, right? Same G can take that. G is equal to, we can take that 2020 only. Right. See, if I write for what simply I am taking that G is equal to some other way. For easy number is so. Okay, no problem. I will take 2020 only. 20 only, right? So there exists some for every, right? That means if I take G also, the terms of SN N square are greater than G. For what stage, for what values of M, right? If I M is equal to 100, that 10,000, right? So for what values of M, it will be approaches to N square, nothing but 20, root 20 is equal to how much here? Not only like this, you can take any other values also. 10 square 100, 20 square equal to 20 is equal to 400, 25. So, for what values of it? I think if I take M is equal to 20, so 35, 40, 40 equal to 40, 40, 1600, 48. So there exists M 48 here. I am taking that M is equal to 48. Why? Because there exists M 48. These N square, SN here, N square. SN is greater than G for N greater than 48. That means you can exist to 47 maybe also. That means SN is high positive. Why? Because if I write 48 square, so 48 whole square is greater than 20. 48 square is greater than 0. For after greater than 40, right? You can take that n is equal to 49, not only, right? N is equal to 49 because here this is n greater than or equal to this value, right? So greater than or equal to n is greater than or equal to 49, right? 49. So that means after this quorum, you can apply easily 25 equal to 2500. If 49 is greater than, that means if I take any value, any g, the term of sequence is greater than this only. Okay, so that's why lim of, simply can observe that lim of n square is equal to infinity. You can observe this by definition. If I apply this, it is equal n square equal, if you lim of n square equal infinite whole square equal infinite whole, right? So yeah, this sequence is divergent to infinity. So here Sn equal to this, so n equal to y pen, I t equal to 9866 there. There again m is equal to one number. If I take this, m is equal to 9866200010, that means this is greater than g. That again, so if I find any g, there exists a greater than element of in the sequence which is greater than or equal to this element. If I take m, so Sn equal to infinite. N square same, this value square, m is equal to 99330. If I take like this, so Sn square, same 9866 I am taking here. This whole square is greater than this. This whole square is greater than g. So therefore, lim of n square. Similarly, lim of n square plus 1 is equal to infinity. Lim of n square plus 1. That means if I put limit here, infinity will get the sequence is divergence. Lim of sin equal to infinity. Lim of cos equal to infinity. Lim of n into n plus 1 equal to infinity. Other way also, a sequence Sn is said to be divergence to n minus infinity. For every g greater than 0, there exists emblem j plus such that Sn is greater than minus. Lastly, I am taking that it divergent infinity, Sn is greater than g. Here, it divergent minus infinity, Sn is less than minus infinity. So that means it is denoted by lim of n tends to infinity minus infinity, or lim of Sn equal to minus infinity. Here, minus is nothing but minus 1, minus 2, minus 2, Sn equal to S1, S2, Sn equal to minus n. I am taking that g is equal to 9866200, m is equal to this. So that means, so Sn is less than minus g. Minus is nothing but 9866600. Here 9866600010 is less than minus g. Minus g nothing but here 9866200, right? This turn of sequence is as is. If it is n greater than this, so the sequence Sn is less than minus g. Sn is minus g. Sn nothing but we can take other extra term here. This Sn is this. That means not only this, we can take other term. So if I take any big g, so Sn is less than minus g. In the sum sequence we get to other element. Therefore, the sequence is divergent. Simply what you do, you put limit here, lim of minus n cube is equal to minus infinite. Lim of 2 power of minus n equal to minus infinite. Lim of minus 1 equal to minus infinite. Lim of minus n into n plus equal to minus infinite. So if lim of Sn equal to infinity and lim of Sn equal to minus infinity, then the sequence Sn is called properly divergent sequence. If lim of Sn equal to infinity and lim of Sn equal to minus infinity, then the sequences are called properly divergent sequence. So one is lim of n equal to infinity, n is properly divergent sequence. So lim of n square infinity, n square is properly divergent sequence. So lim of 3 power n equal to infinity is properly divergent sequence. So lim of 3 power minus n equal to infinite minus 1 whole power is properly divergent sequence. So that means lim of 1 equal to infinite or minus infinite, then the sequence are called properly divergent sequence. Simply what you do, then put limit of, apply the limit to the sequence. If you get infinite or minus infinite, they call the proper divergent sequence, right? According to definition, just it is difficult to find the m value, but if we put that easily, we can find whether the given sequence is divergent or convergent. So thank you for watching this class. Okay. Thank you one and all for watching this class.